Hello guys, this is Sushant and welcome to Sai Engineers. This is our second video lecture for our random questions. I hope the new format which we are following for these videos are helping you. If you have any comments on that, please do share with us how do you feel about the new video pattern which we are doing. This format is just for an experimental basis for now. We will be continuing with our video lectures after MHCET for engineering also. So please do stay tuned for that, and please, if you are new to the channel, please subscribe to our channel, please like our videos, and please do share with your friends. I would like to remind the new subscribers or new viewers that we also have video lectures for each and every chapter for MHCET Mathematics. So please do go and watch it in the playlist for MHCET. So let's get going for the first question for the random questions for our video 2. So our first question, as you can see, is dependent on my definite integration. As you can recollect, we have not done this particular chapter, so we will be covering most of the topic through these video lectures of this particular chapter. So let us go through how we can solve this particular integral. Now let this be I, the integral part of it. Now we have a sec square x. Let us write it as 1 by cos. So that's going to be 1 by cos square x plus my cosec can be written as 1 by sin square x. So we'll be getting this as cos square x into sin square x dx. So now my sin square x plus cos square x is 1, and this 1 upon cos square x sin square x, if I multiply and divide by 2 square, I can get this as a 4 integral. Please, I am not writing the limits, but they are considered over there. So it's going to be 1 upon, this is my 2 cos x, this is my 2 cos x sin x the whole square, which is basically the formula for sin 2x. So it's going to be a integration of sin square x 2x. Now 1 upon sin is nothing but cosec. So that's going to be integral of cosec square 2x dx. Now I know my integral cosec square is nothing but minus cot x. So that's going to be cot 2x divided by 2, because you have to divide with the coefficient. That's the basic integration which you should know. So my limits are going to be pi by 6 to pi by 4. So you will be substituting the upper limit and the lower limit. So when you are substituting the upper limit, it's going to be 2 pi by 4, which is going to be pi by 2. You know that cot pi by 2 has a value 0. So that is why, first of all, this 2 and this 4 gets cancelled out. So that's going to be leading to minus 2 into the first upper limit is going to be 0. And lower limit, that is minus the lower limit, when you are substituting pi by 6, you will be getting it as cot pi by 3, which is nothing but the value 1 by root 3. So you will be having the value as 2 by root 3. Moving to the next one, we have integral minus 10 to 10 log of a plus x upon a minus x dx. Now you can see that it's going to be minus 10 to 10. So whenever you are having such limits that minus a to a, you have to check for the even and odd function. So to recollect that, it's just checking whether it's going to be, whether if you substitute your x as minus x, either if you're getting it as minus f of x, then the integration is going to be 0. If you're getting this value as f of x, then it will be twice the integration of 0 to a f of x dx. So recollecting that, let us check whether the function which is given inside is going to be an even or an odd function. So basically what you have to do is you have to just substitute your x as minus x. So your function f of x is, in this case, it's a log of a plus x upon a minus x. So if you are replacing your x by minus x, you will be getting this value as log of a minus x upon a plus x. So since you can see that this thing has been inverted, And since it is inside the log, what it is basically, it is minus of log of a plus x upon a minus x, which is nothing but your minus f of x. So since you are getting your f of minus x as minus f of x, this particular integration which is given to you, that is a minus a to a log of this function, it's going to have the value 0. Moving to the next question, we have area bounded by the curve which is given to us, that is y is equal to x square minus 5x plus 4 and the x-axis. Now since it is x-axis which is given to us, it should be your integration f of x dx, wherein we will be taking the values of x, that is from a to b. So now for this we don't know what is the value of a to b. So what you have to do is, you have to find basically the roots of this particular equation. So what you will do is, you will substitute x square minus 5x plus 4 in this, you will take your y as 0. You will be finding the roots of this equation. So now basically these are the values of your a and b, or the lower and upper limit, which is, that is the lower limit is 1 and upper limit is 4. Now your area which is to be found out, it's going to be equal to integral 1 to 4 of f of x, that is x square minus 5x plus 4. So that's going to be integral of x square, which is x cube by 3, minus 5x, that's going to be x square by 2, plus 4x. You'll be substituting the upper and the lower limit inside it. So if you calculate this particular value, it's going to be leading to 9/2. Moving on to the next question, we have the PDF of a CRV, that is a continuous random variable x, which is given to us, which is defined as f of x as a into e raised to minus ax, wherein this is defined for the all the positive values of x, and my a is going to be some positive value and it is 0 otherwise. They have given me that the probability of my x being between 0 and k is going to be 0.5, then what should be my value of k? Now since they have given me that probability of this particular thing, that is between 0 and k, is 0.5, so we have to take the integration as 0 to k of f of x. So my f of x in this case is defined as this particular value. So since a is constant, it can be taken outside. It's going to be integral of e raised to minus ax and dx equals, since the value is given as 0.5. Now this integration is e raised to minus ax, which is going to be e raised to minus ax by minus a. So you are having the a outside divided by minus a for limits k 0 to k. So this is going to be 0.5. Your a gets cancelled, you have a minus sign which is along with it, so that minus sign will stick with it. You will be substituting the value, that is upper limit, as e raised to minus ak, and the lower limit is going to be minus e raised to 0, which is going to be having the value 1. Since you are having the negative sign, it's going to be, this is going to be positive and this is going to be negative. So now what you can do is, you can solve this. So we'll be getting it as e raised to minus ak is 0.5. So now taking log on both sides, you'll be getting this as minus ak is equal to log of 0.5. If you can see in the option, there is nothing which is of 0.5. So what you can do is, you can convert this 0.5 as log of 1/2. Now it is, since log of 1/2, it's going to be minus log of 2. So the minus sign will get cancelled with the minus ak. So you'll be getting the value of k as 1/a log 2. So that's your option B. Moving on to the next question, we have a exponential term which is e raised to half dy by dx, which is given as 3 raised to x, and we have to solve this particular differential equation. So what you can do is, you can take the function as it is, e raised to 1/2 dy by dx is equal to 3 raised to x. Now taking log on both sides, that is natural log on both sides, so you'll be getting this as half dy by dx is equal to x into log 3, which is your natural log 3. Now, in this, what you will be getting is dy by dx is having the value which is 2x log 3. Now, my 2 log 3 is nothing but a constant. So, what you can do is you can separate the variables. So, my dy will be equal to 2 log 3 x dx. Integrating both sides, you simply it's going to be integral of dy, which is y, is equal to 2 log 3, which is a constant term. So, that's going to be staying as it is. And integral of x dx. So, my x dx integral is going to be x square by 2 plus c. So, your 2 gets cancelled. So, your answer is basically y is equal to log 3 x square plus c. So, if you check out for the option, it's going to be your B option. Moving to the next one, we have another differential equation which has to be solved. That is root of 1 plus cos x into dy by dx is equal to root of 1 minus cos y. Now, since again this can be formed into my variable separable form, so let's take that equation. So, you will be having a dy by this root of 1 minus cos y, which is equal to dx divided by root of 1 plus cos x. Now, applying the trigonometric formula, that is 1 minus cos y is nothing but 2 sine square y by 2. So, that's going to be dy divided by root of 2 into sine square y by 2, which is equal to dx. This is going to be 1 plus cos x, which is nothing but the formula for 2 into cos square x by 2. So, your root gets removed and the root 2 can get cancelled on both sides. So, you will be having a dy divided by a root of sine square, which is going to be sine y. So, that's going to be nothing but 1 by sine is nothing but cosec y by 2 dy is equal to, this is going to be 1 by cos, which is going to be sec. So, you have sec x by 2 dx. Integrating both sides, you will be getting the integral of cosec and integral of sec. Now, my integral of cosec is going to be log of cosec y by 2 minus cot y by 2 divided by 1 by 2. So, that's going to be a 2 along with it. This thing will be equal to integral of sec, which is going to be a log of sec x by 2 plus tan x by 2 along with a 2 again for the same reason, that is you have to divide by 1 by 2. This is going to be plus c. Now, since we have a log term, what we can do is we can take it as a log c. Let us take a 2 log c. Anyway, it's just a constant term. So, the 2 gets cancelled. So, we have, if we take the anti-log on both sides, so you will be getting it as cos y by 2 minus cot y by 2 is equal to c into sec x by 2 plus tan x by 2. So, you will be getting the option that is my B option for this. Moving to the next question, we have a distance of this point from the plane which is given to me and measured parallel to this particular line. So, what is given to me is there is a point and there is a plane. Now, what I have to do is have to measure the distance of this point from this plane using a line which is going to be parallel to this particular line. So, if this line is going to be such way, so this line which is going to be passing through this point and parallel to this line should be the point. So, it's going to be this particular point and this distance which I have to find. So, let this point be P and this be A. So, now what I have to do is I have to find first of all the equation of the line which is going to be passing through my A and P. So, for that what I require is my point is given, that is my A point is given, and the directional ratios of the line which is going to be which this line is going to be parallel to is given. So, I can construct that line. So, that's going to be x minus 1 by 2, which is equal to y plus 2 by 3, which is going to be equal to z minus 3 divided by minus 6. Let this be some lambda. So we'll be getting the x value as a 2t plus 1, the y value as a, sorry, it's, so you'll be getting your x value as 2 lambda plus 1, your y value as 3 lambda minus 2, and your z value as minus 6 lambda plus 3. So now what you have got is, you have got any point which is going to lie on this particular line. So what you have to do is, now you have to use the equation of the plane. So in that you will be substituting these values. So what you will be getting it as, a 2 lambda plus 1 minus y value will be 3 lambda plus 2, and z value will be minus 6 lambda plus 3. This thing will be equal to 5, and you have to find the value of lambda. So you will be getting the lambda value as 1/7. So now you have got the point P. So your point P will correspond to this particular value of lambda. So that's going to be corresponding to the value that is 2/7 plus 1, comma 3/7 minus 2, and minus 6/7 plus 3. So now you have got your point P, and you have the point A also. So your distance AP is going to be nothing but a root of a 2/7 plus 1 minus 1. So that's going to be 2/7 the whole square plus 3/7 the whole square, because it's going to be 3/7 minus 2, a minus of minus 2 the whole square. So that's 3/7. And plus minus 6/7 plus 3 minus 3 the whole square. So if you solve this particular equation, you'll be getting the value as 1. Moving to the next question, they have given that if one of the two lines is represented by this equation is a bisector of the angle between the two lines, that is my xy equals 0, then what would be the value of my m? Now, since they have given that the line which is going to be represented by this is going to be angle bisector of my the equation which is xy equals 0. So in this case, my xy equals 0 is nothing but the equation of my pair of lines, that is my axis, that is my x equals 0 and y equals 0. So they are just my x and y axis. So my required line that is represented by this equation is going to be bisector of my axis. So that is basically, it should be having the value of 45 or minus 45. So that's basically the slope of that line should be either a plus 1 or a minus 1. So that is why your option should be C. Moving to the next question, we have, if my f of x is given by this and it is continuous at x equals 0, then what should be my value of f of 0? So you have to find basically the limit of this particular thing at x equals 0. So what you can do is, you can use directly your L'Hopital rule. So it is 10 raised to x derivative which is to be asked. So it is 10 raised to x derivative which is to be found out. Your 10 raised to x derivative is going to be 10 raised to x log 10 plus 7 raised to x log 7 minus 14 raised to x log of 14 minus 5 raised to x log 5. This thing divided by a 1 minus cos x derivative is going to be cos x derivative is going to be minus sin x, so it's going to be sin x. So again, you can see that this is division by 0, which is not proper. So you have to take one more derivative of this. So you'll be getting this as 10 raised to x into log of 10 the whole square plus 7 raised to x into log of 7 the whole square minus 14 raised to x into log of 14 square and minus 5x raised to log of 5 the whole square. This thing divided by sin x derivative, which is going to be cos x. So now if you substitute the value of x as 0, you will be getting a non-0 by 0 form. So your value is going to be log 10 the whole square plus log 7 the whole square minus log of 14 the whole square minus log of 5 the whole square. So what you can do is now you can simplify this. So let us take the log 10 and log 5 together. So that's going to be a square minus b square form. So that's going to be log of 10 minus log of 5 into log of 10 plus log of 5. And this thing, you can take this two together. So you'll be getting it as, let us take the minus sign outside. So that's going to be log of 14 minus log of 7 into log of 14 plus log of 7. So after solving this, what you will be getting it as a log of 10 by 5, that is 2. And this is going to be log of 50 minus, this is going to be log of 14 by 7, that is 2. And this is going to be log of 14 into 7. The log 2 common from here, so you'll be getting it as log of 50 minus log of 14 by 7. So that can be taken into the denominator part. So solving this, you'll be getting it as log of 2 into log of, if you simplify this, this is going to be 7 and this is going to be 25. So you're having this as log of 25 by 7, that is 7 square, 49. So you can take this thing as 5 square upon 7 square, that is 5 by 7 the whole square. So you can take it outside. So that is going to be log 2. So that is going to be 2 log 2 into log of 5 by 7. So if you check out the answer which is given to us, that is log of 4 into log of 5 by 7. You have already log of 5 by 7. You don't have log of 4, but your 2 log 2 can be written as a log 2 the whole square, that is going to be log 4 into log of 5 by 7. So your option should be C. So thank you guys, that's the end of our second random video section. So please do share, please do like, and please do subscribe to our channel if you're new to the channel. We'll be doing these videos on a regular basis till your MCET exam. Please do comment how do you like this particular format of videos which we are doing. So thank you. So keep learning, keep watching, and happy learning. So take care, bye.